And then I had to tell her the password. And the password was my own name. I just had to tell her my real name.
Hello and welcome to the pilot episode of Killjoy Storytime. Today I have a thread called The Finnish Skinwalker. Now, of course, all of the original links will be in the pinned comments in the description below. Now join me on this story. Heading for in a woods with a bunch of maids somewhere in Northern Europe, we decide to hike to this abandoned Cold War era facility. Reach the facility after 2 days of hiking. Shit is cash. We spend the day exploring and plinking birds with our 22s. By nightfall, we set up camp in one of the empty warehouses. We go outside, set up a campfire, and start making stew. All of a sudden, we hear the loudest and weirdest roar I've ever heard. We all shit ourselves, grab our rifles, and stare into the darkness. Something is moving about 100 meters out. We hear it rushing around through the woods, into the facility area. Then it stops, and suddenly it's dead silent all around us. Just a stew, slowly boiling on the fire. We look at each other and have a brief chat. We decided to carry on making the stew. Next morning, we wake up and start packing. Everybody's making jokes about how we got scared of some bear, etc. My buddy sees something working on top of the biggest facility building. We try and have a look at it, but it's too far away. Something like 200 meters, maybe. It's just standing there with two legs, probably staring at us. The thing is huge, maybe over 7 feet tall. Reach for my binoculars, have a good look at who's trolling us with a ghillie suit. Just as I find the binos, my mate starts shouting. I look at the creature, or whatever it was. It seems to be running via the facility wall like a lizard or something, very fast. It disappears behind one of the big bunker structures. We decided to nope the fuck out of there. We're scared shitless even though it's day. As we're hiking back, we didn't take any breaks before nightfall. As soon as sun sets down, we make camp and start preparing supper. Everyone's a little tense, and we try to joke around. We decide to do guard duty during the night. My shift is 0103. Birds are singing like crazy. They do that during the night here. And I managed to see a lone rabbit hopping around our campsite. I would have popped the fucker, but I want to let my buddies rest. Suddenly the bird stops singing, and the rabbit stops. Raises its head like it's listening to something. The rabbit nopes the fuck out of there very fast like it's running for its life. I feel very uneasy and flick on my flashlight and shine it towards the darkness. I'm hoping to see a glimpse of a fox or something that could have made the strange behavior of the other animals, but the forest around us seems very empty. Just as I'm putting the light out, I see something move behind the bushes around 100 meters out. It was something big. I shine the light directly at the bushes and try to get a look at it through my 10/22 scope. I managed to see something moving there, and I believe I saw a pair of yellowish eyes. Then it stands up. I don't know to this day what the fuck it was, but it was hairy looking, very dark, and had a face. The face of lighter color, and there were two yellow eyes. The thing was around 7 feet tall, somewhat human shaped. Although I didn't get a very clear look with my shit tier flashlight, I was 100% sure that that thing wasn't human. So I started panicking, raised my gun, and lit that fucker up. I emptied the whole 25 round Butler Creek mag in about 3 seconds. I didn't even aim. My buddies woke up and started shouting, and it was all chaos for a half a minute. I tried to tell them what happened as fast as I could. Having dropped my flashlight, I didn't know if the creature had been hit or it was even there anymore. One of my buddies picked up the light and directed it at the direction I was pointing my gun at. And there it was. Just standing. Suddenly the thing just kind of falls down and starts slithering at us, making no noise at all. We started screaming, grab our packs and guns, and started noping out of there. We must have ran like 10 kilometers straight up before taking a break. All of us were shaking. We didn't share a word. We walked the rest of the way to the public campground in DEFCON 1, weapons ready and listened to every crack. I've never been as happy as I was when I saw some German tourists grilling sausages by their RV. They were all like, what the fuck, when we exited the woods with guns and a low ready stance. We We said nothing, walked to our cars and drove away, breaking pretty much every speed limit on the way. We talked about the thing on the way home. None of us knew what it was, but everyone had seen it and everyone was convinced that it was not human nor normal animal of any sort. We decided to stay away from the woods for a while. Problem is that the wildlife around here is scared of people, even children, and there hasn't been one bear sighting in over 80 years. Continue, the best has come. Last summer we decided to be tough guys and find out what the hell that thing was. This time we would go with 3 ATVs, in case we would have to bail out fast.
We took 2 cameras, 3 308s, 1 1276 with slugs, there were 4 of us by the way, a load of survival gear, and one of my buddies managed to get a Gen 2 night vision camera. We also had several pipe bombs, black powder, and 2-inch iron tubing with caps at the end, plus visco fuse in case shit got out of hand.
Yeah, it was kind of lame, fake operator tier shit, but we thought we'd all get famous and shit if we actually killed it or got footage of it. Anyways, we entered the woods with our gear and headed for the facility.
Again, at the facility, everything looks normal and the birds start singing again. No sign of anything abnormal. We decided to map the surrounding area and look for anything suspicious. Nothing was found. We make camp at the very same warehouse as we did last time. Night falls and everything is still normal. We have guard shifts during the night, but nothing happens. The next day, we start exploring the woods around the facility. We find a particular pile of dead trees. Looked like someone had hauled them here. We take a closer look. The trees are arranged in a fashion similar to a fuck huge bird's nest. In the middle of the nest, there is one half rotten moose carcass and a shitload of different animal bones. We start quietly noping back to our campsite. We parked our RVs next to the warehouse where we keep our camp in. We enter the camp warehouse and see our camping gear all torn up, the somewhat expensive cameras smashed against the floor, food taken and sleeping bags torn to pieces. Fuck. We take everything we could in like a minute and start driving the hell out of Dodge. It's evening by the time we get back to public campground. A police officer stops us by the gate and checks our gun permits. Then the officer proceeds by asking whether we wanted to volunteer for a search operation. Our ATVs would be very much appreciated. Some hiker had apparently gone missing in the nearby forest, 20 kilometers from the facility site. We look at each other and shake our heads. One of my buddies quickly says something about being late and we drive out of there. The dude who went missing was never found. We decided that we wouldn't go in a woodsing in that part of the country anymore. No, he didn't, sadly, but there you go. Dude who went missing actually was found. Local police released this to the media. Unfortunately, if you try to copy the link is dead.